guys! So today I'm going to be doing my August wrap-up. And despite the small number of books in the thumbnail, I actually read a whole lot this month because of a few things. One, I still had my Kindle Unlimited free trial at the beginning of the month, so I read several novellas, which were really short, so obviously those were easy to read. And then also this month, I discovered a few important things, incredible things. One, public libraries exist. Two, Libby exists. And three, Libby has audiobooks. And four, audiobooks are great. So I had a really great reading month. I've not bothered to count up how many books I read because it's a lot. There we go. I'm trying to open the iPad that I've got all my books list or my Goodreads pulled up on. So because I have so many to talk about, we just need to get going. So the first book I finished this month was This Life of Mine by Victoria Lynn. This is book two in the Chronicles of Alira. And I really enjoyed this one. It is, let's see, it's about, so content warnings for, human trafficking and, miscarriage / forced abortion. The characters were really great in this. It was a really sweet relationship. I really loved it. And, the last scene really made me tear up. If you have had a miscarriage or anything like that, like if you have lost, especially if you lost a baby, but probably also an older child as well, this story might resonate with you, so recommend this one. Or it might trigger you if it's been recent, so with that in mind also, like, do with it what you will. Do with that information what you will. But yes, really enjoyed this, gave it 4.5 stars. And then I binge read the Forever After Retellings series, and this series retells fairy tales in Regency settings. These are just clean reads, not there weren't any faith elements, I don't think, beyond them going to church occasionally, but these were still all really fun. So Beauty and the Baron, The Captain and which was a retelling of obviously Beauty and the Beast, The Captain and Miss Winter, which was a retelling of Snow White and Rose Red, not Snow White of Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs fame, different Snow White story. The Steadfast Heart, which is the Steadfast Tin Soldier. A Beautiful Love, which was the Ugly Duckling. Maiden in the Tower, obviously Rapunzel. And In Pursuit of a Gentleman, which is the Gingerbread Man. I enjoyed all of these. I gave all of them 4 stars, except for Maiden in the Tower, which I gave 5 stars. This one was my favorite. Loved it so much. It was so sweet and precious. And just, the ending. The ending. Yeah, loved that. Loved that one. Since I have so many books to talk about, I'm just going to kind of hit the highlights and keep going. I also read this month The House at Pooh Corner, which of course I read to my son. This is just, it's Pooh. Need I say more? It was 5 stars, obviously, because it's Pooh. I also read Put Me in the Zoo by Robert Lobsher. It's not, you know, Dr. Seuss, there's Cat in the Hat on it. It's that kind of a book. Again, read to my son. Still don't know why they didn't put him in the zoo. I don't understand why they wouldn't do that. I then read Life Flight by Lynette Eason. Book one in the Extreme Measure series. This one was really fun. Really enjoyed it. The killer was pretty creepy. Let's see. Let me look at my review just to make sure because it's been a while. The killer was pretty creepy, but wasn't in it much. Like, we weren't in his head very much. And also I put in my review that it was great that none of the mistakes that were made because they were incompetent. I don't really remember that specifically. I remember the bare bones of the story, not necessarily the details. But yeah, nice to have competent characters. And then also I just love the couple. Next I finally finished The Letters of J.R.R. Tolkien. I'm going to hold this to the side so that you can see. But yes. Okay. I think I gave this 4 stars. Let me check. Yes. Okay, I've been reading this since April. I took a huge break in there just because I fell off and just did not do it. But basically, lots of Middle-earth related stuff, lots of not Middle-earth related stuff. Some go check my Goodreads and go look at like my posts, my history for this, for any letters that I really recommend or just good quotes. But yeah, Tolkien is very witty in some of these. In some of these, he's very dry and boring. Yeah, so this one was one that I gave commentary throughout as I read it. So recommend going and reading that. I don't want to take the time to list it all off, but, yeah. Next, I read, Very Funny Elizabeth, since last month I had read the Felicity series with Old American Spirit, I wanted to read this one just to go as a corollary. I thought about reading my American Girl Mysteries that I have, which I may still do, because we're still going to be doing some American Girl related buddy reads. So, yes, hopefully this month. We need to set that up, actually. But anyways, I wanted to just go ahead and read that. That was just a fun... It wasn't... I didn't remember anything about it beyond just it existing, but... It was... great. It was great to just see it. And I also... it was great to see Elizabeth taking the forefront there. And, Felicity wasn't in as much as I would have liked her to be, but obviously it is about Elizabeth, so I guess that makes sense. But, yeah. It was also interesting to see Elizabeth's family and, like, see a closer look at Banana Bell. Then I also read To Darkness Fled by Jill Williamson. Let's see. There were some, in case you're kind of like me and a little leery of magic, there, just so you know, there is some, like, kind of borderline witchy kind of magic, but it's only used by bad guys, and it is said specifically to be derived from demons. So I was okay with it because it is portrayed like real world witchcraft is. Gave this one 4 stars. Fun sequel. I need to read the last book. Okay, then I read the Avatar The Last Airbender Imbalance comics. Basically, I needed a comic manga graphic novel thing for Beautiful Manusha's summer book bingo, so I was like, well, this was the only one that Libby had that I could get immediately, and I wanted to just go ahead and get it over with so I wouldn't have to think about it. I had some issues with this. It was enjoyable. Like, it was fun to see the characters, and they were all in character perfectly from the series. But, basically, I have a talked about it in my review on Goodreads, so go read that if you want specifics. But, basically, it kind of implies, based on, like, just how things play out, that Aang was bad at his job. So, I was not a fan of that. But it was still just kind of fun to see all these characters together. And, let's see. Then I read Finding Lady Enderley by Joanna Davidson-Politano. This was my first Politano book, and it will not be my last. I really enjoyed this. Let's see. I did not see some of the twists coming, that's for sure. Second half was great. The first half kind of dragged for me a little bit. Let's see. What else did I have? Also loved all the literary references. That was really great. So yes, 4 stars for that one. And I gave 3 stars to the Avatar comics that I mentioned last time. Then I read, like I said, I read a lot this month. 5 Children and It by E. Nesbitt. This was just really sweet. These 5 kids, well, 4 kids plus their baby brother, find a, what is it called? A Samid? Yeah, a Samid. That can grant wishes, one a day. And, so they always wish for things that turn out to not be the greatest things. And he, they were kind of, like, I feel like they should have caught on to, like, stop making wishes accidentally a lot sooner than they did, but it was still very fun. I gave it 5 stars. I love Nesbitt's writing, and I have got to read more Nesbitt. That's for sure. All right, then I read If I'm Found and If I Live by Terry Blackstock, which is books 2 and 3 of the If I Run trilogy, and these were really great. I gave If I'm Found 4 stars. Let's see. I love Casey as a character. Casey is just wonderful, and I loved seeing her faith journey. It was, yeah, she was great. For book 2, content warning for, as I put in my Goodreads review, the worst kind of child abuse imaginable. And then, book 5, or book 3, I gave 5 stars. I really loved this ending. It was exciting and climactic, and several twists I did not see coming. And, also, I was legitimately scared for the characters, even though I was like, I'm pretty sure it's all gonna work out fine. I still got worried for them, so that's always great when that happens. All right, next I need to make a full video on this. I finished reading Planet Narnia, or I read Planet Narnia this month. So this is very dry. Planet Narnia is. It is basically a summary of how Narnia, like the planets on how the 7 Narnia books connect to the 7 medieval planets and, like, the conceptions and, what is the word I'm looking for? imagery and just like mythological connections that the medievals made with the planets, and how those connect to Narnia. It also talks about Lewis's other like scholarly work, Lewis's poetry, and the Space Trilogy. And the Space Trilogy stuff was so cool. Like, that was my favorite part of this because that was not in the Narnia Code, which is the shortened version of this book that I really recommend you read. I'm not sure if I recommend this one necessarily. I only gave it three... No, I gave it four stars. Okay. Let's see. And I think he is very correct. I think he is correct about this. I think he has cracked the Narnia Code, as it were. One thing to note is that he does discuss... In the Mars chapter specifically, I don't remember for sure if there's any in the Venus chapter, but definitely in the Mars chapter and possibly Venus, there is discussion of some imagery that, while Ward handled it as tastefully as possible, I think, I still was kind of a little, I don't know about this. And I'm not, yeah, it was just not my favorite subject. So, kind of not inappropriate in the way he discussed it, but, you know, not the best thing to talk about. All right, next... I read Unknown Threat, which is... See, I read this whole series this month. I know I read the whole series. I'm questioning if I read it this month. I did. Not? Yeah, I did. Where's book three? There it is. Okay. Yes. I did. I read the whole series this month. Okay, so I really enjoyed this series. So this is about a group of friends, Book one is about an FBI agent and a Secret Service agent in Raleigh, North Carolina, which is kind of weird to think about those two agencies being there, but apparently they are. And this was really fun. Book two is about another one of the Secret Service agents and, his romance with, this is a romantic suspense. I read these for the Keep Me in the Suspense readathon, which I participated in. That's also why I read the If I Run. And, anyway, where was I? Oh, yes. Book two, one of the Secret Service agents and his childhood friend who now owns a, I think it was like a biotech company or something. I'm not confident on, now at this point, I'm not confident on what her company did. But that one was childhood friends to Mort, which, you know, I love that trope. And then, the third one is about the last two Secret Service agents getting together. Both of them together. I really love this. My favorite thing about Lynn Blackburn's books that I discovered this month is I love her friend groups. Her friend groups were just... And also Lynette Eason, which we're going to get to. I read several of hers, too. We're going to get to those. Her friend groups, both of them, they're just so great. Like, the Secret Service friend group, for example, they... anytime one of them was in danger, which was a lot because these are romantic suspense books, they would just all rally around that person and protect them, which, yeah, they're also in protection, but still, like, it was, like, as their job, but still, it was so wonderful just to see these friends just stick together no matter what. It was great. I also read Dangerous Deception by Evelyn Hill for the Keep Me in Suspense readathon. Basically, this was just a, I needed to read 11 parts, so I found this one on my library app, and I was like, on Libby. I was like, well, I'll read this one. It was about, what was it about? Let's see. Oh, yeah, it was about a woman who lives in a small town, and then a man comes and tells her that she's not who she thinks she is, and that she was actually his fiancé, and... that she's in danger, and she doesn't believe him at first, and then things escalate. I think I gave that one 4 stars. That one was pretty fun. It was pretty predictable, but still pretty fun. And then I read Undercurrent of Secrets by Rachel Scott McDaniel. This one was really good. It was about a steamboat coordinator, like wedding coordinator for on a steamboat, and her and, or she's just doing her job, and a man shows up with a picture from the 1920s with somebody that who worked on that steamboat, and then it's dual timeline. So we have cut to the past timeline of this person in the picture that he has, and they're trying to we see her life. So that one was really fun. I gave that one 4 stars. Let me see if I. Quite a few twists I did not see coming. in that one. All right, I think that's the last of my physicals. Like I said, I read a lot of ebooks and a whole bunch of audiobooks. I read a whole bunch. I read the rest of the Extreme Measures series also this month by Lynette Eason. So the first one was Laugh Flat, which I talked about a while ago. So I read Crossfire and Critical Threat and Countdown. And I really loved all of these. Again, it was just, yeah, they were just really fun. Basically, the romantic suspense this month was just really fun. I read a few and then I got in the mood and I just kept reading them and they were just really great. Yeah, not a lot to say. Again, loved this friend group. Book one, he is a FBI special agent, I think, and she is a helicopter pilot for, like, Life Force, ambulance, but helicopter. Except going into, you know, dangerous situations and stuff. Book two, she is an FBI hostage negotiator, which was a really fun thing to watch, and he was a school resource officer, I think. So, content warning for book two for a school shooting, in case that is, you know, something you have issues with. I think that was, yeah, it was the hostage negotiator one that had the school shooting. Pretty sure. Yeah. I'm just double checking that to make sure. Alright, Critical Threat, book three. She's a FBI profiler. Sort of, at least. I don't know if she's officially a profiler, but she tries to get into the, not fully into the head, but, you know, tries to understand serial killers so that she can help stop them. And she works with a guy who's a prison psychiatrist who is also the son of a serial killer. And then all of a sudden bodies start showing up that follow his dad's MO. And he's like, everyone is very confused because his dad is in prison. For sure, his dad is in prison. Like, they know for a fact he's in prison. So it's just sort of figuring out like what's going on there. That one was enjoyable as well. And then the last one, she is the paramedic on the ambulance helicopter that the first girl flies, and she is, that is not a long description. I don't really know how much I can say. Basically, people from her past come back. Someone from her past comes back into her life and is trying to, kill her, basically. I mean, I think I can just say that. And then, what was he? A marshal or a special agent? He's a marshal. So, U.S. Marshal then comes along and is helping protect her. And then I read Double Take by Lynette Eason, which was also a, romantic suspense. I loved the, again, another great friend group. Can't wait to read the rest of this series. I gave all of the last series 4 stars, and I gave this one 4 stars as well. I read the Kaylee Quinn Profiler series by Nancy Mell. I gave these 4 stars, but I didn't love them nearly as much as the other ones. I think because what I was loving in the other, I think the reason I didn't love these as much as I loved the others, and I think the reason was because what I was reading the others for was the friend group, and Kaylee very much did not have that. But I did enjoy these still. They were great twists and turns and stuff. Yeah. I also read the Danger Never Sleeps series by Lynette Eason and really enjoyed those. I gave almost all the romantic suspense I read this month 4 stars. So these were Collateral Damage, Acceptable Risk, Active Defense, and Hostile Intent. Like I said, just enjoyed those. I read Beneath the Surface by Lynn H. Blackburn. Dive Team Investigations, Book 1. Yeah. And I read, in August, I read the first 3.5 books in the Blue Justice series by Lynette Eason. This one's about a family who are all in law enforcement, almost. Book one is, what is her name? Izzy. She is a police detective. Book two is about Callie, who is also a police detective, but she is, a canine officer. Content warning for book two, especially for, human trafficking. That's it. I should know, I know those words. I promise you I know those words. There was a lot of that in the romantic suspense. I guess just because that makes for good high stakes. Book three is about, which one is book three about? I don't even remember book three. Emily, what? Three is about Brady. Oh, yeah, okay. Brady, the brother, who is also a detective. And then book 2.5. Book 2.5? Why did I read book 2.5? I finished them on the same day, I guess. Is about the one sister who did not go into law enforcement, Ruthie. She is a surgeon, and somebody shows up that needs protecting. And even if she is a surgeon, she grew up in a law enforcement family, so she knows things about she knows about things like this. So that was all that I read this month. That was a lot, I know, and I kind of just glossed over a lot of things, but that's because I had so many to talk about. I also participated in the Keep Me in Suspense readathon, as you could tell by all of the suspense books that I read. So here is my bingo board. I did have to count one book that wasn't suspense. Somebody, I think it was Amanda, said you could do that. Oh yeah, the hosts for that were Caitlin from Chronicles of a Book Nerd, Jeanette from Jane Reads, and Amanda from Book Lover Amanda. I think it was Amanda who said you can count non-suspense books. So I had to count a non-suspense book for the book you own but are dying to read. Because, or whatever that prompt was, because I don't own any physical copies of suspense. And then I also blacked out my summer book bingo board, which I am super happy about. That was super fun. So thank you, Tiffany from Beautiful by Nisha, for putting that on. Whew. And I'm losing my voice. So, and it's late. I had to wait till the baby was in bed. So I'm just gonna sign off. thank you all for watching. Leave me a comment. Let me know what the best book you read in August was. My favorite. Ooh. Well, because I got on my kick of romantic suspense, honestly, my book might have been those. Or, ooh, no, Maiden in the Tower. Maiden in the Tower is probably my favorite of August. But of the romantic suspense, the only one I gave 5 stars to was If I Live. But I think I don't know. I may need to revise some of those ratings because I really loved a lot of those. Yeah. Of the Lynette Eason series, for sure my favorite one was the Extreme Measures series. That one was my favorite series, I think. Yeah. All right, so thank you for watching. Like I said, leave me a comment, and please like and subscribe, and I will see y'all next time. Bye.